Welcome everybody, it's good to see you here. Welcome everybody, it's good to see you here. Welcome everybody.
In last week's test and protect data, 120 people went to places of worship during the infectious period. 120 people. That creates a risk that I am unwilling to take in the advice I give to the decision makers. The decision makers then choose what to do with that advice. That's their job. But inside that advice, and particularly because of a broad demographic attending places of worship, all age, all disease, and you can't protect those individuals, I'm afraid, robustly enough, then at this point in the pandemic, I think it's the right thing to do. And particularly because of a broad demographic attending places of worship, all age, all disease, and you can't protect those individuals, I'm afraid, robustly enough, then at this point in the pandemic, I think it's the right thing to do.
Thank you. And there are, you know, there are reports of outbreaks, as we know, and particularly in the US there have been several reports of outbreaks from churches and... All the faith communities of the UK have been extraordinarily responsible in the way they tried to address this. There is some very weak data to imply that, that even if the place of worship has been incredibly good about being COVID secure, by bringing people together, people can congregate outside and do things which actually do lead to transmissions. But these are very variable, and I think a lot of this is anecdotal, so I think we should be a little bit careful about putting that out as this is a scientific fact, this is just reported behaviours.
The government has set out five tests that must be met before we begin to adjust social distancing measures. One of the most important tests is the rate of infection. We have to make sure this is decreasing. All viruses, like normal flu, have a rate of infection. Scientists call this R. R is the average number of people one infected person passes a virus onto. To beat coronavirus, we need to keep R as low as we possibly can. Imagine 100 people are all infected. If R is more than 1, then those 100 people will infect more than 100 people, and in turn, they will infect even more. The virus is spreading quickly. If R is less than 1, those 100 people will infect fewer than 100 people, and in turn, they will infect even fewer. The rate of infection is slowing down and coming under control. Scientists around the world have been tracking the R of coronavirus since the start of the outbreak. In March, at its peak, R was around 3, which seems to be the natural rate for this virus. Since then, thanks to you and the social distancing measures you followed, we've been able to reduce R. And it is now below 1. But we've only just passed the peak of the virus, and it's vital R stays below 1. Over the coming weeks and months, the government will be monitoring R very carefully. It will be a key factor in how social distancing measures are used in the future.